It's been ground zero for the Omicron outbreak. 16 aged care residents dying with COVID every day this year.
Since the onset of Omicron, some 682 people have died in aged care facilities.
That's more aged care deaths than the entire of 2021, and even more than Victoria's deadly 2020 wave.
It has been an incredibly tough time for those who have been working in those facilities, and it has been incredibly tough for those families who have had to say goodbye to loved ones.
And a tough time too for isolated residents and their families who've been crying out for help as more than half of aged care facilities across the country locked down.
We're in amber. We can't go out of our rooms.
I was very sad there for a while. You did get down, yeah.
She said that she just doesn't want to go on. What is there to live for if you can't go out? What's the point of life?
On Friday, the government announced relaxed restrictions for aged care facilities, allowing access to one visitor per resident per day, even during outbreaks.
To ensure that instead of a blanket lockdown for an entire facility, that it's much more nuanced.
One Victorian aged care provider is taking things even further with an approach that treats COVID more like flu or gastro outbreaks.
It's not gastro. No matter how much you want it to be something that's manageable like that, if we start to not have things in place to protect people from COVID, then we're going to have a lot of deaths from COVID.
But while flu comparisons may be controversial, TLC Healthcare says the approach has served it well. Its 11 centres avoiding lengthy lockdowns and remaining largely COVID-free.
We're in a different time period now where we have vaccines and we need to kind of create a balance between mental health and COVID. But I think we always need to understand that many elderly people are still at risk of serious consequences of COVID.
So how do we balance the right to life with the right to truly live?
John Pascuzzi is the Chief Executive of TLC Healthcare and he joins us now. Lou, can you tell us more about this flu or gastro-like approach that you're taking to COVID outbreaks? And what I mean by that is, like, what does it look like in practice?
Oh, look, 5 years ago, Waleed, when we opened medical centres, community medical centres within our aged care homes, we were able to basically PCR test and or rapid antigen test and vaccinate sufficiently ourselves. And ultimately that resulted in an ability to isolate a potential virus penetration in one of our residential aged care homes to a couple of rooms or a corridor or indeed at worst a wing rather than lock down an entire home. And basically what we've done now is take that, I suppose, modus operandi, appropriate it to COVID, and it's been working quite well now for the last 8 weeks.
Hey, Lou, I'm so confused. Have you been telling me that this whole time you've had a rapid antigen test for gastro?
No, not for gastro, but there has been rapid antigen tests for flu, for influenza for a long time. So when rapid antigen tests weren't in vogue 6-7 months ago, we decided to engage very high sensitivity-based rapid antigen tests approved by the TGA. And we mandated rapid antigen testing for anyone entering our homes, so staff presenting for their shifts, contractors and visitors, as well as we regularly tested residents weekly or if they were symptomatic. And rapid antigen tests have saved us from the best part of around 170 outbreaks.
Lou, I reckon you sound like a great salesman and the only people you have up against you is pretty much all the experts. Epidemiologists are saying that this isn't like the flu, this isn't like gastro, and it shouldn't be treated as such, especially not with the most vulnerable members of our community. So what do you know that they don't?
Well, theory's great, and it's been policy on the run for the last 2.5 years, and a lot of epidemiologists are commentating and stating the bleeding obvious, but not really assisting anyone really to manage this virus. So we've taken it upon ourselves with our clinicians, And we have succeeded. We after November, we've had the odd outbreak here and there. Rather than locking down the entire home, once we identified those residents, again, we only locked down the areas in which they resided, and for the 7 days only. And it's been fantastic in that, yes, you have had the odd one or two that have had to go to hospital. And we had a couple that had to go to hospital as a result of their acuity levels and comorbidities. But they since have come back recovered and ultimately we haven't had to lock down an entire home to do that, to achieve that. We've been at the forefront of management of COVID over the last 2.5 years and we're really proud of what we've achieved.
Lou, thanks so much for speaking with us tonight, and it sounds like the results you've been getting so far have been good. May they stay that way. We appreciate your time.
Thanks, Waleed.
So the problem with aged care, of course, is you've got all of those different sorts. You've got government-run, you've got state government-run, and then you've got private like that. He's clearly been ahead of the game with that flu testing, and it's worked, but you just look at what happened in Victoria in particular in 2020, where we had lost over 800 people to this. So good on him if that works well.